Welcome back, learners. Today we are diving into another way to work with arrays in JavaScript, focusing on the forIn loop. This might seem similar to what we've done with forEach, but forIn has its own special use cases and caveats and is a little easier to use in my opinion. So let's explore how this loop can be handy on the ServiceNow platform. For the first part of our lesson, let's go back and review some of our other looping methods. And as a reminder, all the scripts that you will be seeing can be found at devlink.sn/sn-js if you want to follow along at home. But let's review some of our older looping methods. The first one is our for loop and then our for each loop. So let's walk through this. You'll see that at first I'm building an array of fruits. So in this array, it's just a bunch of strings, apple, banana, and cherry. And then in this for loop, what it's saying is if we have a variable declared I equals zero, and as long as I is still smaller than the length of this array, then do the code that's within this loop and then increase I by one. And so if you remember from Chuck's original lessons, this is a very common way to do for loops, to iterate through everything within an array. So that you can execute a code for everything inside of that array. And then the other way to do a loop is for each. One of Chuck's later lessons reviewed this. You basically say the array name and then for each, and then you give it a function. And then you, similarly to the regular for loop, you iterate on each item and give it an index. So you'll see as I run this script, it has the same results for both. For loop, at index 0, we have apple. At index 1, we have banana. At index 2, we have cherry. And for the for each loop, the same thing. At index 0, we have apple. At index 1, we have banana. At index 2, we have cherry. So that is a very common way to do loops on arrays. Now let's talk about a different way to do an array loop. I'm going to start off with my same array, and I'm going to instead type var index in fruits and build my array this way. And notice it's a lot cleaner of a for loop, and it's a lot more simpler to read, and this is one of the reasons why I like using it. And then from here, the code is very similar to the last one. So we're going to say, let's create a log statement for in loop to know which one kind of loop we're doing at index and give it the index variable. We have fruits and then the index of where we are in the array according to the loop. And there you have it. Very similar to the last way we did for each. But it's a lot cleaner in terms of what the syntax looks like. And if I run it, you could see that for in gives us the indexes as strings. You can use them to access the array values, just like the other ways that we do loops. And it has the same result. So it's just another way of doing a for loop. And it's just a fun, clean way to do it without having to say, how many times are you going to go through the loop if you are assuming that you want to go through every single item inside the array? And then finally, for this lesson, I do want to talk about one caveat about using the for in loop that you may run into in your testing and in your scripting that makes it a little bit different than the for loop and the for each loop. And that's specifically what happens when you use custom properties inside of your array. You'll see that I made two arrays in here. So fruits is our original array that we've been using. And then I've also created a vegetables array with avocado, broccoli, and carrot. And then for both of the arrays, I've created a custom property inside both of those arrays and declared them as a string, not an array. As in treating the array as like an object, I'm giving it its own property to sit next to the actual array of indexes. So I'm going to run a for loop on the original array of fruits, and then I'm going to run a for in loop on vegetables and see the difference. So you can see here on the fruits array, it's the same result. At index 0, we have apple. At index one, we have banana. At index two, we have cherry. That ran exactly as we expected it to as before. But let's look at the vegetables array. At index zero, avocado. One, broccoli. Two, carrot, just as expected. But then at index custom property, we have not in an array. So it took those properties that we declared on the array and also displayed them in this loop. It's not likely to come up very often in your scripting because not many people set custom properties on arrays. But if you ever run into a situation where more things are appearing on your for in loop than you're expecting, that's why. And that's it. That's the for in loop. All right. Thanks, everyone.